Let's talk entertainment, specifically the Jensen system on the Travato. Hey y'all, welcome to Ginger Walkabout. So today we are talking entertainment. Woohoo! As you probably know, the Travato comes with a Jensen stereo system built in, and it's got various speakers inside and out and subwoofer and whatnot. Not a lot of people seem to like the Jensen. I don't have a big opinion on it, which I know is unusual. I usually have an opinion on everything. But it might be because the thing basically stopped working 6 months after I got the van. And I'm just now getting around to doing something about it. And I'll show you what it started doing. So let's get inside the van and talk about this Jensen situation. Okay, so here we have it, the Jensen stereo system. It's also got a DVD player, which I don't even know anyone who has DVDs anymore, but some people might. Anyway, and in theory, you can hook up your TV through this and have better audio, AM, FM, CDs. Again, who has CDs? And then the most useful would be the Bluetooth, right? Hook your phone or whatever up via Bluetooth and play your music through that. So there are two sets of speakers that come in the Travato. There's the inside ones, which are underneath here, underneath that dinette cabinet, the silver things. And then there are two outside speakers. And there are three zones on the Jensen. So zone one is inside, zone two is outside, and there's a third zone that you can hook up something else that you want to hook up. It's already wired. So if you wanted to put like speakers in the back or something like that, you can do that. They're actually labeled A, B, and C. And I believe A is inside, B is nothing, and C is outside, or vice versa. Anyway, again, I quit using it. I quit using it. And here's why. All right. So originally I had my phone Bluetooth to it, and it was fine. I also had my computer Bluetooth to it so I could listen, because I took the TV out. So I have a monitor and I stream all my entertainment, all my movies and TV shows. And so I have my computer Bluetooth to the Jensen so I could listen to the audio through the Jensen. And all was right with the universe. But then this started happening. Oh boy. There it is. That's what starts happening, y'all. It is really that loud. Out of the speakers. It is that loud. All right, so obviously none of that noise is okay. And at first I thought it was the speakers, but it's not the speakers. And then I went on the Facebook group, and this is a known issue with Jensen. So I called ASA. They are the parent company of Jensen and the customer service people that you call. And they were very nice. So Lucille the van is out of warranty. She is. I've had her for more than 12 months, and she's got more than 15,000 miles on her. But the ASA people were like, "Well, there's a grace period, then there's even a little bit of a grace period on the grace period." And so this is why it never hurts to ask, y'all. Always ask, because to replace this unit is about $450. And so, but ASA was like, but you gotta go talk to Winnebago to go through their warranty dealer situation. I was like, oh God. So I call Winnebago customer service and they're like, yeah, well, you gotta go to a dealer. I was like, why can't you just ship me a new part? 'Cause I can swap them out. That's easy. They're like, well, the parts actually get shipped by ASA and it has to go to a dealer and blah, 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 blah. And I was like, oh, sweet baby Jesus. And I explained to them, I live 2.5 hours from the nearest dealer, and I, you know, it's 6 months to get in to see them if they'll even give me an appointment. Thanks, McLean's. Love ya. Anyway, so they were like, we'll call ASA back. I call ASA back, and they were lovely. They were like, okay, we do swaps. So send me some information, and we'll get you a return authorization. Send the unit in. We will test it. If it is broken, we will send you a new one. If it is not broken or there's physical damage, like you broke it, then we will send the old one back to you and you are just SOL. I was like, Dunskies and Dunskies. So I'm about to pull this unit out. I'm going to show you how super easy it is to pull out. We're going to send it in and we're going to see if we can't get a new Jensen unit. All right, so to get this thing out of here, so there's these little plastic trim pieces on each side. You just pop that out, a little flathead screwdriver. And then you got 4 screws. So we're going to take those out. All right, so the 4 screws are out. And now she just pulls right out. I don't want to drop it. I'm doing this with one hand. And back here, you're going to find hooked up. That's power. You'll see there'll be a HDMI cable hooked on there too. That just goes through the cabinet and out to the outlet over there, I guess, so you can plug the TV in. I don't know. Anyway, I unplugged that. And then the wiring harness. So they don't need the wiring harness at Jensen. They want you to just keep that here, because if you detach that, ooh, lordy, you're going to be in a world of hurt trying to get all those back in there. So we're just going to, you know, unclip it and unplug the power. And that's all she wrote. All right. So she's unclipped. And you know how I love to play what's behind the walls. So if you're ever wondering if everything stops working entirely, there is a fuse right here in the Jensen. So you could always check that. Here's the end of that wiring harness. And that wiring harness connects to some more wiring harnesses. So remember, you're going to outside speakers, you're going to a subwoofer under the pantry cabinet, you're going to inside speakers. You can see one of the inside speakers right here. And then back here is your little coax splitter, right? So, you know, there's multiple points. There's 3 places where you can hook. I hope y'all can see that with the light. There's 3 places where you can hook up cable or hook a TV up to the van. And so this is your cable coming in, and then it splits off so that you can get runs to the other 3 places. Quite frankly, I could take this entire thing out because I don't even have a TV. So, but I'm going to leave it. Anyway, and so people that hate the Jensen and just take the Jensen out entirely, you know, you could certainly cut this whole thing out. I mean, there's, you know, that space goes down in there. You could cut this whole thing out and have a really big storage area if you wanted to do, you know, what normal people do, which is just hook a stinking Bluetooth speaker up to your phone and go about your business. Anyway, so that's our latest edition of What's Behind the Walls. All right, I'm going to put the screws in here so I don't lose them. And she is all ready to go to back to her Jensen home in Elkhart, Indiana. Going to get her packaged up and shipped off. And hopefully when they test her, they will figure out that she is bad. And they will send me a new one. So off we go. All right, so I shipped out the Jensen. I took it down to the UPS store. And to package it up and ship it, it was $62. But I figured that was worth it if hopefully they were going to give me a new one. So this was over the holidays, so I didn't really know exactly how long it was going to take. But lo and behold, in less than 2 weeks, arrives on my doorstep a big old box. And inside is what appears to be a brand new Jensen. So let's see what we got here. I don't have any indication that they returned. I don't think they returned the old one.
This looks like a new one to me. Oh, California, and your warnings. Everything will give you cancer. Oh, look. There's a handy dandy use thing reference guide. Huh. I don't think I got that in the Travato when I bought it. Maybe I did and I lost it. I don't know, but that's helpful. All right, so that looks to me like a brand new Jensen. So let's get this thing unboxed and into the van and see if that solves the problem. All right, so interestingly, the Jensen comes with things that Winnebago doesn't give to you. Well, I got another remote, so that's good, I guess, in case the original one goes missing. I assume the remotes all work with the Jensens. I don't know. I'll have to check. There's a wiring harness that obviously we're going to use the one that's still in the van. But anyway, there's a package of stuff and a brand new Jensen. All right. So I got it up here. I got it all hooked up. I got the wiring harness plugged back in. I put the HDMI cable back in. I'll get to that in a second. It doesn't fit very well. It doesn't, like, it's kind of loosey-goosey, so we'll see if it stays. And then the power cable. And we have power. So we're just going to put it back in its hole and screw it in. All right. Well, before I screw it in, we should probably see if it works. So here we go. Okay. Oh! Oh! Look at that. Broke the sweetest promise that you never should have made. Woohoo! No crazy buzzing sound. That is awesome. Jensen replaced. And hopefully the buzz will not come back. If it comes back, we got, I guess, a different issue. But anyway, there she is. All right, I'm going to screw her back in, and we'll be done. So there she is. Let's get the... I hate when people leave this plastic on stuff. Drives me nuts. I know, you're protecting it. Mm-mm, stop it. Looks tacky. It's like plastic on couches. Anyway, so there it is. I got a brand new Jensen, free of charge, except for the $60 shipping, courtesy of ASA. The manufacturers, who are absolutely lovely human beings, and I was out of warranty, and they gave me a grace period on my grace period and sent me a new Jensen. So if this one goes out, then we got a Winnebago bigger problem. But so far, I am super happy, except for one thing. All right, so another thing people really love to complain about in the Travato in the entertainment area is the outside speakers. Apparently these are crap. And I would actually tend to agree with that assessment. So that one is still working, but it's all crazy staticky. And that one, I don't think is working at all. So, yeah, I wanted to confirm once I got the new Jensen to make sure, but my feelings were correct that the speakers on the outside of the van are blown. So, yeah, I got these Marine speakers. So these are Marine certified. These are the Polk 5 1/4 inch. The Travato owner and wannabes Facebook group says these are the speakers that fit up there. I got me some 3M Marine adhesive sealant that I'm going to use. Seems easier than a big old cock gun and all that. Anyway, so that's the next project. We're going to be putting those in. So yeah, I hope that will then solve the entertainment issues that I've had in the van really for quite some time, and give it a much better user experience. I mean, I'm actually going to be happy, if I can, you know, hook my phone up and use the speakers again. That'd be nice even for me. So, yeah, so that's, stay tuned for, replacing the outside speakers, and then we should be good to go. So I have a question that I need y'all to help, because y'all have been so helpful thus far with my getting ready to rent the van situation, right? So as you know, if you've been watching, I took the TV. Hang on, I'm too close. Let me move down here. Small van, y'all. I took the TV out and put a monitor in. A bigger monitor with this, you know, crazy mount that mounts up there. And then I can tilt the monitor down. And then I hook my little Nook computer up there on the wall behind it. And off I go. So I am thinking, if I'm going to rent the van, what needs to happen is I need to take this out. I think I need to take this out and put the original TV on the world's dumbest mount back in here. Because right now, if I leave the monitor in, whoever rents the van has to bring their own computer, laptop, I'm assuming, unless they have a Nook or a microcomputer, with them to plug into the monitor in order to use it. It's a monitor, so you can't use it as a TV. So you can't like use the cable or the antenna or anything or the Fire Stick or anything on it. So I'm thinking I'm going to have to take this out, put the regular TV back in. That way people can use it that way. And then when I travel in the van, I'll just bring my laptop. I mean, you know, I'm not full time anymore. So I'm not working in here constantly. If I have to work on my laptop, you know, for a week or two, not the end of the world, right? All right. So y'all let me know, right? Put the original TV back in or leave the monitor. I'm really leaning towards putting the original back in. But you know, again, I like your feedback. I think my subscribers out there give me good advice. So anyway, stay tuned for replacing outside speakers. Let me know on the TV versus monitor, and I will see you on the road.